Well, there we go, people. I find myself in this situation once again, where basically I can't seem to get off to sleep. Now, in another video, some time back, can't remember when it was now, but I said, well, when I have difficulty getting off to sleep, what I'd normally have a tendency to do is pop down in the kitchen and get some wires out, okay? So I think in this little midnight video, which is 3:30 in the morning because I just cannot get to sleep, I'm going to get some wires out and some bits of test equipment and have a little bit of fun with some clamp meters, I think. Okay, so we have to be really, really quiet because, I mean, sort of, you know, if I make any noise, the neighbours are going to hear it. And goodness knows what else. And it also might accidentally end up waking up the Tobias. Okay, no doubt he can hear me anyway because those little ears of his are so, so sensitive. So, at 3:31 in the morning, let's have a look at have a little look at the setup that I've got for this video. Okay, I was planning to shoot this video around about 8:30 last night, but didn't get round to it, so I thought to myself, well, I'll do it the next day then. But 3:30 in the morning, I just cannot get off to sleep, so I thought to myself, right, all that stuff I've got set up, I'm going to get that out, I'm going to set it up on the kitchen worktop 3:30 in the morning, and let's do a little video. So have yourself a look at this. Well, okay then, there's that connector, and for the more established subscriber on BoomBox Deluxe's channel, you will know that that red connector is connected to the output of my little tenant puppy. Just there. Okay, now I've got something connected into the output of tenant puppy, and it's one of those transformers. Okay, one of those ones that I do fan loading transformers with. Have yourself a look at what I've got connected into it and what we're going to have as a little bit of fun around about 3:30 in the morning. Okay, then we've got one of those little phantom transformers plugged in there, and just behind those you can see a couple of clamp meters. Now, in another video some time back, what I've done is, it was out in the garden funnily enough, but not at 3:30 in the morning. I got a couple of clamp meters, one at a time. I got a Dialog DL6402. We had a little bit of fun with it in various different ranges. And I also got it's made by Rapitest, and it's a MS2002. We also had a little bit of fun with that, again, on various different ranges on it. What I was going to do, like I say, 8:30 last night, was to get out both of those clamp meters at the same time, get them on that transformer, on that that piece of wire sticking up there, turn the Variac up a bit, and let's see what both of them say when they're both on there at the same time. Okay, let's see if they say exactly the same thing, or if they differ, by how much. I've got to turn on the little 10-amp puppy, so it's going to be a little bit in rush at 3:30 in the morning. Well, not surprisingly, there's very little or no inrush. This may be because half the flipping neighbourhood have gone to bed and there's not much load on the transformer over in the substation. So there we go. Right, I've turned on a little 10-amp puppy, and we got things all fluxed up, I'd seem to think so anyway. Let's go over. To there. Okay. I've got the zoom right in, haven't I? Let's zoom out a bit. Actually, I might as well leave the zoom like that, but just bring it back a tad. There we are then. So, for this evening, we've got, well, evening, flipping halfway in the morning. Got a couple of clamp meters there. Okay. Dialog DL6402. And then we've got the little Rapitest one there, which is an MS2002. They've both got different ranges on them. This one has got, if it would get a zoom on it, but you know, the camera's like for zoom people. There we are. So we've got a 40 amp, a 400 amp, and a 1000 amp. Okay, now this one, unlike that Rapitest that you can just see through there, this one you can do AC and DC on the clamp. That one over there is AC only. Again, it's just a little, I wouldn't say it's a budget one, but it's a little cheapy unit. Okay. Yeah, that one over there, you can buy that and get change out of £20. This one costs you the thick end of £100, okay? It's a little bit different and a little bit more professional. This one, we've got on it, it maxes out with 200 amp, and then we've got a 20 amp range and a little 2 amp range, okay? So setting both of these up so we can get both of those on there at the same time is going to be a little challenge. I don't plan on pulling 40 amps because that little transformer down there is only 30 amps, okay? So we're going to have a little under 30 amp fun tonight, okay? Those wires down there, they've been shorted out so we get a bit of a current flow going through. And we've got to get the clamps on there at the same time. So what I'm going to do in this vid, I'm going to get our little Rapitest, okay, and put it on the 20 amp range like that, okay? So we're going to be going up to 20 amps on this one. Then I'm going to be setting this on to the 40 amp range, okay, which is the lowest of the ones on the little Rapitest down there. That's mid range, okay, because we got 220 and 2 on this one. Got 1440, so it's the lowest on this one. As soon as I turn that up to there, this one comes alive. Here we are then. Now it says direct current there, so I'm gonna have to select it onto alternating current by pressing the mode button. There it is. And on this one, I don't know why, but it always sort of hovers around about 30 milliamps, so I have to zero that like so. There we are, so that's zeroed. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on our little Rapitest one. And there we are, that is stabilised. Okay, AC because it does AC only anyway. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on the little 10 amp puppy then. We're going to get this one on first because this is one with the lowest range on it. Okay, with a maximum of 20 amps. Straight away, I haven't even turned up the little 10 amp puppy yet. We've got that would be 360 milliamps on there. Let's get some proper amps going though. Right, there we are then, almost 12.5 amps. So, 12.5 amps, and it's just stabilised. Now, what would the dialogue say about that if I put the dialogue on at the same time? Let's move that over a bit. I'm just trying to nudge that tripod with my shoulder. So we've got 12.5 amps on this one, but what will the dialogue say? Will it say the same thing? Well, interestingly, no. Oh, hang on, they're both sort of adjusting a bit. Maybe they're affecting each other. Actually, they're quite sort of pretty much the same, aren't they now? Yeah, I've got a feeling that transformer's warming up a bit, so that load's going down. Yeah, they're more or less sort of in the same ballpark as each other, aren't they now? Now they've sort of stabilised off a bit. But then having said that, maybe one is affecting the other one. If I take the dialogue away, let's see what the little rapid test says when the dialogue disappears. Well, that's interesting. That's dropped right off all of a sudden. I'm wondering if I've got a loose connection there somewhere. Yeah, I've got a feeling I've got a loose connection on that transformer or something. Because that's really all over the place now. So we've got 15.5 amps now. Now I've wiggled that about a bit, so I might have a bit of a high resistance connection somewhere. Let's 15.6 amps now. Let's get the dialogue back on there and see what it says. Yeah, they're pretty much in the same ballpark as each other, aren't they? So there we go. That's interesting, isn't it? They're a bit sort of slightly different to each other, but there you go. I almost had them both the same then. But there it is, almost the same. Right, now I've just checked the time and it is now 20 to 4 in the morning. I'm going to just leave those there, like that. Okay. And, well, here we go. I'm going to turn down the little 10 amp puppy. Here we are then. 1.97 amps and 1.9192993. So there it is. Now at 1.992 amps I could probably put that other one on the little 2 amp range. I'm going to do that now, see what happens. There we go. So we've actually got 1.92. It's all over the place a bit. But that would actually be 920. It is all over the place, isn't it? Well, let's just say 1900 milliamps then. Yeah, that is all over the place for some unknown reason. It's going down continuously as well. I got a feeling it's just adjusting because this one says 1.78. So I've got a feeling this will probably it's starting to stabilise there. So there we go. It's a we're roughly sort of in the same ballpark figure as each other, aren't they? So there it is. Righty-o then, people. I'm going to turn the big dog off now. Big dog? It's actually 10 amp puppy. It's getting late in the morning. Right, so there you go. They've both gone to zero now. And I think basically that signifies the end of the video. I'm going to turn off the little rapid test. Like so. But what I'm going to do, because that is currently set on the little 2 amp range, to save me accidentally popping it, I'm going to turn it on the full-on 200 amp range and leave it like that. With this one, however, you can't leave it on something and turn it off because you've got to rotate that down to the off on this one, like so. So there it is. Nice bit of clamp meter fun. Okay, now I've got to go for 15 minutes. So I hope you enjoyed that one. Get on the comments box and let me know what you think.